So hello everybody, this is Shivam back again with a new video on a video series of right now it's all about CHAM, GATE and GSI. Since you know that CSI exam already completed, now onwards I will try to solve geology numericals. Mainly I'm going to focus on geology. Okay, so aaj se har Sunday ko, and even I will try to make a video on Saturday also. Initially I will try to make videos on numericals problem only, since it is in demand right now. Okay, so this is my channel. Over here you will get lots of video regarding the same, so please check this out, it will really help you. So let's start some numerical problems. Okay, so basically I am going to solve some questions from mineralogy. Okay, so let's start our first question. Okay, let's take a red color question. A Hertzbergite contains pure phosphorite and pure instatite in molecular ratio 60:40. Okay, the mole percent of MgO in the rock is, we have to find mole percent in the rock is dash. Okay, so now let's see how to solve this. This is easy, right? So given is, we have a Hertzbergite contain pure phosphorite and pure instatite in a molecular ratio 60:40. We have to find the mole percentage of MgO. Okay, so let's write formula. Mole percentage of a component is equal to number of moles of that component by total number of moles present in the mixture. And since we have to find percentage, so we'll multiply with 100. Okay, now let's see the formula for phosphorite. For this type of question you should know what is the formula over here. Okay, so formula for phosphorite is basically, it's a magnesium silicate. Okay, so here we can say that we can also rewrite this equation as 2MgO into SiO2. Clear, right? See, here we have 2Mg here also. We have 4 oxygen, so 2 oxygen and 2 oxygen over here. So total 4 oxygen. One silicon is over here. You can write like this. Okay, so now one mole of this phosphorite has 2 mole of MgO. See, 2 mole of MgO and 1 mole of SiO2. Okay, now let's see for instatite. Okay, so the formula for instatite is, again this is magnesium Mg2Si2O6. We can write like this also, MgSiO3 into 2. We can write it like this, and we can also write it like this, MgOSiO2. We can write it like this. Is it possible or not? What we can do is, see, we take a common 2, so we can erase like this. See, let me erase. Let's take a common 2. See, 2 is over here, 2 is over here, and 2, 3 is a 6. So we can write MgSiO3. Okay. And here we can write MgOSiO2. Possible? Now, 1 mole of instatite has 1 mole of MgO and 1 mole of SiO2. 1 mole of SiO2. Okay, now we have everything. So we can write mole percent of MgO in 1 mole of phosphorite, 1 mole of phosphorite equal to 2 by 3 into 100. How it's become 2 by 3? So you can see over here, 2, total how much? 2 plus 1 in phosphorite, see, we have 2 plus 1. What is the formula? Formula is total number of moles present in the mixture. So total mole is MgO plus SiO2 mole. 2 mole of MgO and 1 mole of SiO2. Together it becomes 3. Okay, we can add. So when you solve this, we'll get some value. Let's keep it like this only. Now let's find in instatite mole percentage. Let's change the color. Mole percentage of MgO in instatite, in 1 mole of instatite, in 1 mole of instatite. Now let's see, instatite is over here, 1 mole plus 1, yani total we have 2, and how much mole of MgO? 1 mole of MgO into 100, right? Now we have both the things. So we have to find mole percentage of MgO in the rock. In the rock we have instatite plus phosphorite. So we add, okay, basically to find mole percentage in the rock. Now mole percentage of MgO in the rock is equal to 0.6 into 2 by 3 plus 0.4 into 1 by 2 to 100. That is equal to 60. And that's the answer over here. Is this clear? So what I do is basically added both the values over here and over here. You will get the answer. This is your answer. Is this clear? This is the mole percentage of MgO in the rock. Now let's solve some other question. I hope this is easy to you. Let's see once again. This is the formula. Number of that component by total number of moles present in the mixture into 100. This is the mole percentage of a component. Now here we can see, firstly, you should know formula for phosphorite, then instatite, and then find how much mole is present in the form of MgO, in the form of SiO2, and that's it. Now moving to the next question. So in this question, let's change the color this time. Okay, so an eclogite consists of garnet 60% and omphacite 40%, where the mineral abundance are in mole percent. Okay. And the given formula is like this: Mg by Mg plus Fe2 plus, that is ferrous. Okay, put it in bracket. So XMG, this much of mole percentage, and the formula is over here of garnet and omphacite is given. Both the values are given respectively, that is 0.50 and 0.75 respectively. So we have to find this XMG. Okay, so our duty is to find the XMG, the XMG of eclogite. See, already formula for XMG is given. Okay, so what we need is, we need these values. Now let's solve this. It's very easy. It's really easy. Okay. So here we have question. XMG eclogite. Eclogite. Okay. Now let's see what is the value. 60% of garnet is percent, right? So, and 40% over here is omphacite. So 60% can be written as 0.6. 60 by 100, it becomes 0.6. So 0.6 into XMG, this is into, okay, this is X formula, XMG garnet plus, and here we have omphacite, how much? 40%, so we can write 0.4 for 40% again into XMG for omphacite. Omphacite, right? When we add, it becomes XMG eclogite. So everything is given now. XMG value for garnet is given 0.50. It is 0.50 plus 0.4, and XMG value for omphacite is given 0.75. Okay, now when you solve this, it becomes simply 0.6. This is the answer. This is basically XMG of eclogite. Okay, 0.6. Now this is very easy. Again, go through the question. You can take a screenshot over here, you can make notes also. Okay, easy, right? If you have any doubt, feel free to comment. Okay, now let's solve some question from Kate also. So I have one question from Gate. Okay, let's change the color now. Okay, so question is, a plagioclase, we know we have different types of plagioclase. Basically the trick is AOALBA. Okay, so albite, or you can say simply like that, anorthite, oligoclase, andesine, labradorite, butyvenite, and albite. Okay, so yeah, different techniques. So you can by heart like this, AOALBA. Okay, O for oligoclase, andesine, labradorite, butyvenite, and anorthite, this is albite, whatever the way. So the question is, a plagioclase with Na plus by Na plus plus Ca 2 plus is equal to 0.8. This is given in the question. And the options are, is it albite? Is it anorthite? All are plagioclase only, plagioclase are. Oligoclase, and D is butyvenite. Okay, Now see, we have to think about this one. So plagioclase, we know it belongs to basically feldspar group, and in this plagioclase family we have a example. It's a good example of solid solution. Okay, we have in members like albite, which is sodium rich, and we have anorthite, which is calcium rich basically, and the formulas of albite are basically NaAlSi3O8. This is the one in member. Anorthite is the another in member where we have maximum percentage of, matlab 100% calcium. Here we have 100% calcium. This is your anorthite. Okay, so Si3O8. Okay, so now let's see how to solve this. Okay, so according to this formula over here, whatever given, we can see that this, in the given this thing, the mole fraction of sodium present in 1 mole of plagioclase, right? This is 1 mole of sodium present in 1 mole of plagioclase. In plagioclase we have sodium plus calcium. Sometimes we have 100% sodium, then it's albite. If it is 100% calcium, then it is anorthite. Okay, so it means that plagioclase is sodium rich, since we are taking in numerator this sodium only. So that means it is sodium rich. Sodium rich matlab 100% of sodium, it is always in albite, it's not anorthite. Okay, is this clear or not? If it is 100%, then it is albite. But what about here? Here we have 0.8, yani it is around 80%, it's not 100%. Okay, it has sodium, but the concentrations are not 100%. Okay, so if it is 100%, remember, if 100% sodium, then it's always albite. If 100%, this is for sodium. If 100% calcium, then it is anorthite. Okay, is this clear? So now let's see the options over here. So anorthite is neglected over here, since sodium is not equal to sodium is not equal to 100% over here. Okay, so it is easily neglected. Again, this albite is neglected, because here in a case of albite it is always 100%. Here we can see it is 0.8, yani 80%, so this is also neglected. This butyvenite is eliminated, since butyvenite is calcium rich thing. Okay, so this is also neglected. See, for the formula AOALBA, this is your anorthite. Here we have albite. Okay, so butyvenite is more calcium rich. Here we have 80% of calcium and 20% of sodium. So it means here in this point, here we have 80% of sodium. Now you can see it's easy if you use this technique. This is your anorthite end, this is your albite end, yani here we have 100% of calcium, here we have 100% of sodium, right? So here 100, that means as we move this way, it becomes 80 over here, sodium becomes 80 over here, sodium becomes 60 over here, 40 over here, 20 over here, and 0 over here. This is for sodium. Okay, for calcium, say this is for sodium. For calcium, it is 100 over here, 80 over here, 60 over here, 40 over here, 20 over here, 0 over here. So this is for calcium. Now in the question, what we have? 80% of sodium. See, sodium is in the numerator. So that means oligoclase. all you need is to by heart this technique AOA LPA. So this is your albitin, this is your n-orthitin. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. This technique is very useful. Okay, it personally helped me. Now let's solve some other questions. I hope this is clear to you. If you have any doubt, please feel free to comment. Okay, so now let's solve another one. The question, the birefringence of a mineral of thickness 30 micrometer and retardation 0.27 micrometer is. Okay, so what is the formula for this? Remember, this birefringence is equal to retardation in the mineral by thickness of crystal. Okay, so everything is given, 0.27 micrometer. Okay, is your retardation by thickness is how much? 30 micrometer. When you solve it, you will get 0.009. Okay, this is your birefringence. So here the most important thing is this formula. If you know this formula, birefringence is equal to retardation by thickness of a crystal. Sometimes they ask retardation also. So remember, retardation is equal to thickness into birefringence. Okay, so easy. Now let's solve another question. Any doubt? Okay, so now let's solve some other question. Let's change the color now. Okay, this one. Not this one. Okay, so question is, the retardation of a uniaxial negative mineral of thickness 0.03 millimeter is 5160 nanometer. Okay, one is in millimeter, here it's in nanometer. Okay, that's cool. Is in its principal section, in its principal section of indicatrix, if the refractive index corresponding to the E ray is 1.486, the value of refractive index, then we have to find refractive index for O ray, because E ray ke liye given hai. So now we have to find refractive index for this O ray, ordinary ray. Yes. Okay. So dekho, the retardation of uniaxial negative mineral of thickness is given, is this much. Okay. A mineral of thickness 0.03 millimeter is 5160 nanometer in its principal section. This is the retardation. Okay, in its principal section of indicatrix. If the refractive index of corresponding to the E ray is given, then we have to find refractive index for O ray. Right. So now first, what should I do is, so just change the color. This, okay, retardation of uniaxial negative mineral, how much it is given? 5160 nanometers. Remember, we'll convert this into a meter, so 1 nanometer is equal to 10 to the power minus 9 meters. It's in meter. Now thickness, how much given? Thickness is 0.03. thickness of mineral is equal to 0.03 millimeters. Okay, so again we convert this into a meter so that it becomes easy for us. 0.03 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter. Okay, now both are in meter. For uniaxial negative mineral, we know the refractive index, that is omega, is greater than E. Okay, these are the refractive index for O ray and E ray. Okay, you should know the basic concepts. Okay, for this, so for uniaxial negative mineral, this is a concept you should know. Omega is greater than E. Okay. Now negative means omega is more than epsilon. ये trick है. Okay, याद रखना. Norm. Okay, norm means what? Negative omega more than epsilon. Negative omega, the M for more than epsilon. You should know this. Okay, so omega is greater than E. Now what is this E? This is basically refractive index of E ray, and omega is basically refractive index of O ray. This is for O ray. Remember, you should know all these things. These are basics. Okay, this is refractive index of E ray. Okay, now we should know this formula. Okay, to find basically refractive index values. So T into N slow minus N fast. This N is basically refractive index. Okay, so T into this N slow is over here, which is slow. So over here omega is slow. Okay, so we can write it like this: W minus E. Okay, now this retardation is given. This delta retardation is already given. See how much retardation is: 5160 into 10 to the power minus 9. Here we don't have this omega. We have to find this omega, right? This is basically a refractive index of what? It is refractive index of O ray. Okay, we have to find the refractive index of O ray. So now what? Just put the values. It is already given in the question. It's in meter. Thickness is 0.03. It's in millimeter. When we convert this in meter, it becomes this much into W minus 1.486. We have to find this one. Okay, now just rearrange everything. You will get something like this. When you solve this, you will get 1658. This is the refractive index for O ray. Now let's see how to solve. Everything is given. All you need to know is this formula and concept of norm. That's it. You can check this out again. Okay, Easy, right? This is really easy. This n slow minus n fast is basically birefringence of a crystal. Okay, this is birefringence of a crystal. Okay, so I think with this I'm going to end this session. That's it for the today. I will make some new videos tomorrow morning. Okay, till then, see you, bye bye, and please do comment if you have any doubt.